Is your standing up? In your building? Mrs. Simmons, as long as you're standing up in your building, what was you, how would you answer her about never buying textbooks, buying textbooks?
I think it depends on the school. It depends on the level, okay? I do know that this year in particular, the money that we did have for textbooks was taken away because it was used to purchase math and focus, so we did not have an option.
But we bought math textbooks into every child in elementary school.
So.
The high school textbook money was not removed, it was only elementary.
Yes, it was.
No, high school textbook money was removed.
That was in January after we asked if there's any other purchases and there were none.
That's not true.
Well, that's what we got here. We have your first.
We have a high school principal who's disputing that.
She can dispute it.
I put it in order for textbooks.
Yes, Mrs. Simmons.
Okay. As you mentioned earlier, on the elementary level alone, we are next year going to be implementing a new math program. We are going to be implementing a new literacy program, okay? We are going to be without assistant principals. I would like to know what your plan is, which is the question that we've been asking throughout the year, as to how this is going to take place, okay? What is the plan for next year? How is it that we are going to prioritize an education for our children if there is no plan in place, number one, and if we will not have support in our buildings to make sure that those plans are implemented? That's the first part of my question. The next part of my question is, without assistant principals, once again, in all of our buildings, how are we going to assure the safety of the children who attend our schools? Let me go back to a for instance. This year, I have been working with a 0.5 AP, okay? I have her 2.5 days, she's at Summit Park 2.5 days. We had a code yellow this year, okay? I happened to be in the building alone that day. I did not have an AP. What made it even worse, I had children on the playground because it happened during recess time. I had a cafeteria full of children at lunch, okay? Safety. Mm-hmm. Safety is a priority. I would like to know how we are going to run programs, educate children, and make sure that they are going to be safe as an individual in a building of 540 children, and even now without social workers. Mm-hmm.
I will answer the first part first. We are, and you've been part of this, Pat, so don't play that you've never heard and you've been asking and don't know.
Is now that we have selected, how is that going to be followed through?
Well, that's what I'm going to answer. Now, I just said, you don't know. Today alone, Mr. Dollar and I did the signing off, but Mr. Dollar did all the work. We submitted to be allowed to use a race to the top money, which is approximately $2.2 million over the next 3 years, to do the staff development training using our assistant principals, teacher trainers, whatever the title's gonna be, allowed by the state.
What does that mean?
I just told you what it means.
Did
I cut you off when you spoke? Did I cut you off? I listened to you intently. I'm trying to answer, now you keep cutting me off.
Tell me what it's going to be.
Again, I'm trying to.
All right, everybody quiet so we can hear him clearly.
So what we are doing is we are going to try to use our Title III money, which is ESL, our Race to the Top money, which is for developing the teams, this curriculum support, the data collection and data evaluation to support our curriculum programs. On May 4th, Andrea Cadet will go into great detail and explain all of that in whatever time is needed at that point. But today, what we did is we redid the grant. Mr. Donald, give him all the credit. He did all the work on it. BOCES worked on it to get us permission. We do not yet know if we have permission because it was only sent in 4 o'clock, late this afternoon. We're hoping to get permission, which will then free up $2 million. And then, as I said to you before, then we work out the details of exactly how we support the curriculum K-6. But on May 4th, we expect to have the answer, and we expect on that meeting to give out all the details. We don't have them now. We don't have permission. But we know there's federal funds available, and we're hoping to use those funds to support the principals, but more important, to support the children in the schools for curriculum in literacy and math. That's what we're doing. Oh, wait, you already, let somebody else go.
I understand that, but I didn't want to say something. Because
we didn't get the answer on
Are there other people with their hands up? Let's come back.
No, I want to say it. My question's to again, okay? You're basically saying that we're going to do this without assistant principals. Okay, because let me finish my question. Because you're now bringing in Race to the Top money. That's not assistant principals. Right now, the assistant principals that are in elementary schools, 70% of their salary is being paid out of Title I funds. You put it out as if it's a great deal of money that we are short, okay? It's basically $400,000 that will maintain. The assistant principals are not going to be coming from central office once a month, okay? Assistant principals are in the buildings all day, every day, okay? They have our backs, they support our children, and they make sure that children are getting a decent education. That's what we need. Not someone who's going to come from central office once a month, okay? That's not what we need. The other part of it is, if there's an emergency in my building, I can count on an assistant principal. If there's a safety issue, I can count on my assistant principal. If the children need someone, they go to the assistant principals. That's who they know. That's where the support is. You have basically said, there's no money for them. Okay? You've restored pretty much everything except
only 50%, not everything. 50% has been restored.
Dr. Klein, we know. Okay? We know what's really going on. The education of the children is a priority. The safety of our children is a priority. Children and the safety of our children. That's what we're asking for. Okay, I don't need one person. I don't need a Race to the Top person. I need an assistant principal. Just as every other principal standing here, we need assistant principals. We need to make sure education has not been from the central office a priority. We prioritize. We work hard in the schools. Every last one of these people. We work hard in the schools without support from central office many times. We need your support. We need to know that you're going to stand behind us. We're here for the children. We need to know that. You don't seem to be doing it.